What's poppin', everyone? It's your boy Venomous Stare, the George Wallace of StarCraft 2. This time I have an exceptional Zerg versus Protoss for you between two players who have won major lands in Korea, which if you think about it is actually absurd, especially consider one of them, the Protoss player, is an American. Quite honestly, one of the only Americans to make a splash in Korea since Idra did it. Now, if you're not aware of who Neve is, he is the Protoss in the bottom right of New Gettysburg. His opponent is the exceptional Macro Zerg and winner of a top-tier Korean tournament, Dark. This game is going to begin exactly as the last one did, Game 1, which I also casted on this channel, which was an interesting game. You should go look for the VOD. It was released the day before this video. And Dark opened with the same type of videos, or the same type of build, excuse me, Speedling Expand. This is very good for a confident Zerg who wants to dictate the approach of the game. If you try to go hatchery first and your opponent probe scouts, they can screw you around till the cows come home, man. They can delay you with this probe, they can build a pylon, they can build a pylon at your third, they can cannon you. It really can get out of control. Imagine that, but if all Neeb had to do was build a pylon and Dark would have been screwed. That's what it's like to open hatchery first versus Protoss. So Dark knows that Neeb likes to probe scout, so he likes to go Speedling Expand. This means the ability for Dark to get Speedlings, Queens, and Zerglings out is very, very increased as far as the timing of the issue. Notice how fast these Lings are. They would have been able to fend off a cannon rush. There's a very popular cannon spot here and here on this map. Neeb does not really cannon rush that much. He was a player in Wings of Liberty who played Terran and did lots of aggressive micro-based play, lots of medevac, harass with drops, lots of Banshee play with Hellion. I remember watching Idris stream, and he was playing a Terran versus Zerg on Daybreak. And while he was winning the game with multi-prong drop harass, he started flying his medevacs around in a circle to taunt Idra. And that was one of my first memorable experiences watching Neeb, aka Neeblet. Notice how Dark has taken a third base. Not as quickly as he did in the previous game. He's elected to get two queens. So these games that I'm casting, these BlizzCon games, they definitely, as Neeb gets screwed a little bit here, as Dark gets Zerglings in his base. But these BlizzCon games are best of five, so you need to be watching these games in order. In the very first game of this series, Dark went for a very creative build where he cut drones, went Roach off of three base very quickly. It was an incredibly sharp early hitting all in, and he even only had one queen. So Neeb perhaps is a bit wary of that, but as I say that, he's poised to go take a third as he goes Stargate. Oracle on the way. New Gettysburg is a map that some people say favors Zerg. Part of the reason for this is the relatively wide natural ramp and how wide the ramps are at the third. Now Neeb has gone for an extremely quick third, as we see Dark making spore crawlers. Notice that Neeb made the Stargate in the wall. This is somewhat necessary because you want to get the Stargate as soon as you have the gas, and the way that the timing works out is you have that gas before you want to make your second gateway. So that's why you saw Neeb make his Stargate in his wall as opposed to hiding it. If you want to hide tech versus Zerg, this is a good spot. Notice this is one thing that Dark does almost every single game. He gets very early speed. Neeb is trying to play a little bit of offense here, but only gets two drones. His Stargate was scouted. Whenever you go Stargate in Wallen, obviously it's going to get scouted. Dark, of course, sees it. He has speed Overlord, so he's going to see everything. But even if Dark did not opt for this early Overlord speed, he would have scouted this. Now, it is interesting to note that Oracles are much better when you have the element of surprise. Now you might be saying, Wily, you're an idiot, everyone knows that. Well, what I mean is that you can elect to go Phoenix, and it can be more powerful if your opponent knows you're going Stargate, because Phoenix inherently are guaranteed to get value versus Zerg. They hard counter Mutas. If you go Phoenix, your opponent can't go Muta, because if you have an established backbone of Phoenix, whenever your opponent's trying to go into Muta and harass you, you just deflect his harass with ease and tech into a big army and kill him. Neeb has his third established. He has some sentries over here too. This is nice. Dark is going for a dropper lord, and it looks as though he's going to do some Ling aggression here. Dark is going for this very popular Zerg style where you delay your gas geysers, as we see his macro's a little messed up here. But Dark has two gas geysers. He's getting plus one attack for his Lings. He also has a Baneling nest, and basically he can focus on mineral income and get a ton of Lings, drones, and queens. And at this point we saw an early game attack on Neeb in game one. Now we're going to see a big mid game attack. Notice Dark has cut lots of drones to do this, but this is incredibly scary. We have a dropper lord full of queens, so Dark is really using a creative play here, a queen taxi. And all these banes really indicate to me that Dark is going to pull out a play out of the Demaga 2010 playbook and put on the Bane Rain. So Neeb is going to be hard-pressed to hold this third. This third is completely reliant on ground-based attacks. Neeb is hoping that Dark is going to go for pure Ling attacks, but he's going to ferry right over the force field and drop Banelings onto the important units of Neeb. And suddenly, Neeb has no more force fields and even less hopes to win this game. The Robo base sags out of control and out of commission as the four queens that were dropped off by the Overlord are going to come forward here and scare off the Mama Core as the Mothership Core tries to recall, but it's all a mummer show at the end of the day, because if we go to income, it doesn't even matter because Neeb GG's. So, an exciting mid-game attack from Dark. He says, okay, I'll show you what I think about you trying to take this third. And he kills Neeb. So Dark is up 2-0. Two great players. Subscribe for more. You do not want to miss Game 3.